This is Florida Gulf Coast University.
This is part of a larger project where we're looking at the alteration of the watershed that we live in and the chemicals and the nutrients that run off into the water and how it impacts the estuarine and coastal areas, and the potential for these contaminants to make their way into the human body is great as well. So what we're really interested in is not only the health of the ecosystem, but also look at how these chemicals and nutrients make their way up the food chain all the way to the humans. As part of the broader project, we look at areas that have the potential to develop as oyster reefs, but currently they don't have oyster reefs. For example, we're looking at areas that have high larval recruitment. In other words, the larvae are coming there. There's plenty of food to support the growth of these oysters, and the water quality or the salinity is appropriate or favorable for the growth of these oysters. The disease and the predators are low. In other words, they have all the conditions necessary for development of an oyster reef, but they're lacking the substrate or some kind of hard surface area where the larvae could settle and attach. So those are the areas we target for restoration. In other words, we're going there and putting the substrate or the hard surfaces down. And there are plenty of larvae naturally present in the water. They settle on these created reefs and fairly quickly grow into living, thriving oyster reefs that harbor many, many species.
In the beginning, I was just an intern as well, helping to lay the reef. And then once I became the manager, we deal with all of the logistics that it takes to pull off this event today.
139, 140.
So it takes a year's worth of bagging the shell and coordinating all the boats and the volunteers to culminate to today's event.
This is where the Oyster Reef Restoration Project begins. We get this fossilized shell trucked down to us from a phosphate mine up by Tampa. We then create the bags that eventually become the oyster reef itself. So we use these PVC tubes as chutes to shovel the shell into so that we can then pull them out and tie the bag. And then we stack everything to the side and just continue doing that until we have enough bags to create the reef.
I work for Dr. Aswani Volety a lot, and we go out into several different estuaries and collect oysters, and we look at any number of different parameters on the oyster itself. We collect samples while we're out there, we bring it back to the lab and do a number of different laboratory experiments on them on a monthly basis.
Look at the size of these oysters. Oysters are an excellent indicator species. They're a sentinel species. Since organisms such as oysters are stuck in one place, they make excellent models in terms of making connections between what the effect is, what the cause is, and the effect that the organisms are exhibiting. If you look at a fish or a crab, which is a mobile species, and if it is doing very well or in poor condition, you can't attribute it to the water quality around it because they can move around. If you pick any species that is stagnant in one place, such as seagrasses, oyster reefs, mangroves, you can easily attribute the effects to the cause. What you see here is a new bag of oyster shell that we put out, and hopefully what you'll see in a few years is the bag completely covered with oysters and become a good reef.
Reef restoration started in 2003, and I helped Aswani with the inception of this. So this is my seventh year, so it's been exciting. It's been a big change from back in 2003. We had not that many volunteers, and I mean, just to see this shows you the success. We started small scale. The reefs were a lot smaller. Volunteers, I think the first year we had about 20 people show up. So it was the logistics and just never doing it, getting the boats out here and the people and things like that. And now that we have the community's involved, they've heard about it in the past. We get free t-shirts, which is always a bonus for some people. And we've got the community too. I mean, even government agencies like Lee County's been out here. Sea Grant used to be, which is part of the Florida IFAS program. So we get a lot of the local community out here as well as the government and agency. So we're all working together just to make it a success. And you can see we get 200 people now, and they're eager and can't wait to get out here on a Saturday early.
Awesome. The work on oysters is so related to everything else. And it's amazing to me and probably amazing to the general public that when you really learn to learn about oysters and what they do, how interconnected they are to the health of the estuary, is outstanding. Besides the fact that they are incredible filter feeders, they're cleaning the turbidity out of the water, they're cleaning the water itself, that's going to impact the submerged aquatic vegetation. So it's making the water clearer for the seagrasses to receive better light penetration.
I think restoration is important because we kind of forget about the things we're losing, and this is our chance to give back and recreate. And it's a big scale project, so you can come out and see with the naked eye what you've done. And it's very gratifying, I find.